Hey everyone on YouTube, how you guys doing? So I came across a vid and where a YouTuber took a used a saw blade, circular saw blade like this one, maybe larger, maybe the teeth were larger, and turned it into a knife. And it came out pretty cool, so I thought I would do the same, and I'll put links below who that YouTuber was that I found doing that. So here are my designs. I love karambits, I love knives with finger holes, so drew out the pattern. I think from here to here is just less than 5 inches. I'm going to keep the teeth of the saw blade just for decoration. I wouldn't say this is the best steel to use, so this knife is more for display than for practical purposes. Just a fun little project, because right now I'm in the in a stage, I guess, where I've got 40 knives over at Peter's Heat Treat, and I didn't plan my workout properly. So he's got 40 knives, and I've got no steel, almost no steel, here in the shop. And it really wouldn't make sense to make another batch of 20 knives right now. So I have to wait until these knives come back. Brad from Peter's Heat Treat said, this week, he said that he received my knives and he'll start working on them within the next few weeks. So he must be a busy guy right now. I'm not going to see these knives for 3 weeks. So what am I going to do for 3 weeks? I do have a piece of 3V steel, which I had saved just in case I needed to do something like a custom order. So I wanted to have some steel on hand. And I did receive a PM from a cool YouTuber who would like me to make him a knife. And maybe he'll make me one in trade, so we're discussing that. So good thing I had some steel set aside. But just to keep my hands busy, I thought I'd try this out. It's a worn piece of a circular saw. I bought this from Sears, and I don't know why I kept it, but I've had this at least 10 years. I thought maybe it was cool just to have it hanging on the wall, but I think it's going to be cooler now, turning it into a knife. And here are my patterns. I'm going to keep the hole here is going to be a finger choil. This is already heat treated, but maybe not exactly for the requirements of a knife, but for a circular saw. I'm not going to send it out to heat treat. I'm just going to cut it out, put an edge, maybe test the edge out to see how well it keeps the edge and holds the edge, and make basically a display knife. So recycling what would have been junk or thrown out, because I really can't do anything with it. And I've had this for so long, the edge there is starting to rust. This is all some sort of a tool steel. It's not a carbide bit, not carbide teeth over here. So this is all one piece. But something to play with, something to recycle. And maybe I can get 3 little knives out of this, toys, if anything. If anything, it keeps my hands busy, and yeah. All right, so next step now is to cut it out. I'm not sure if you can hear that, but that's my fire alarm. So here are the knives that I'm going to be working on now. Persian style with a finger choil. That's going to be number one. One karambit. And I'm not too sure what I'm doing with this one because I cut into the, camera's not showing it. I cut into the finger hole. I cut into it, so I don't know if I could salvage that or not. We'll see. Now it's time to grind it out. Okay, so I didn't have time to finish the project. Excuse me. But it was fun. Ended up with a nice 4.5 inch or so Persian knife. The saw blade that I used was very thin. It's about 1/10 of an inch, maybe a little less. In reverse. I mean, the metal here is so thin, and for my liking, I work with 1/4 inch or so type of stock. This is almost 1/3 of what I'm used to using, so definitely not something I want to put a rock pattern on or maybe worry too much about getting the grind lines out, so it's going to end up looking very rustic looking. But since this was such a fun project to get a piece of steel, cut it, shape it, and then put a grind line, which I haven't done yet, I'm probably going to make a trip to the local flea market and see if someone is selling a thicker saw blade, like what they use at cutting wood at mills. So this Karambit looked pretty cool. It's got a nice mean looking stegosaurus spine. Because it's hardened steel, I had a hard time cutting it with a dull bimetal hole saw. It's got a cool looking pommel, which I haven't finished. Everything was pretty much done real quick and rough, so I haven't finished it. And I'm probably going to keep this pattern here, and maybe the gaps will get filled with epoxy when I put a handle on it. But this was a fun project. So many thanks to that YouTuber, and I'll put his link below. Mr. Jax B, I think it is. This one, after looking at it, I'm going to cut this off because the pommel ended up looking almost like a whale tail. So it kind of looks like this evil-looking whale, blue whale or something, with his vicious, spiny plates on its back. I'm probably going to keep the blade shape the way it is now, only because it's different. The whale tail is really cool. And in the reverse. That's what I was going to go with originally, but I kind of like it the way it is now. Alright guys, so it was just a fun little project with some scrap steel I had, or I should say a worn blade that I had, which I was going to throw out eventually, or just using as decoration. And it was just a really cool idea, so props to Mr. Jax. All right, guys. Have a good one. Good night.